Hello, how are you guys? Good morning. I wanted to come on and do some Reiki today. Hope you guys are having a good start to your week. And if you are new here, my name is Molly with Sunflower Soul Healing. And I will be doing Reiki, which is a Japanese healing art, helping to balance and calm your mind, body, and spirit. So just go ahead, sit back, relax, and receive. And just allow me to take care of you for a bit. Reiki does work on our intention. So go ahead and set an intention, whatever it is that you need right now in this moment. And of course, if you are one of my subscribers, please let me know if there's something in particular that you need today, especially when I'm in that chakra. Clearing out your aura, your energetic field before I get started. Beautiful. Well, I am gonna start us off. Good morning. Good morning, Sonia. With a singing bowl to get us started, ground our energy, and to help open that root chakra. Good morning, Andrea. So we are going to work on that root chakra, which is at the base of your spine, red in color. Helping to ground your energy, helping you to feel calm, balanced, rooted. In your body. So just opening up that root chakra, allowing that energy to flow. Releasing the tension, the stress from your head, allowing it to flow down. That root, So that root chakra, helping with any lower back, stagnant energy in your hips, that stuck energy in your hips, helping to clear fear energy. Sluggish, kind of a thick energy where it feels like you're stuck, you know, where you can't move forward. So clearing that. Helping you again to feel grounded and connected to the earth. It's the best way to ground your energy. Just get outside. Sometimes, especially nowadays, we can become very disconnected from the earth, like we're separate, you know. And we're so much up here in our head, in technology, and we lose that connection, that oneness that we have with the earth. You know, it's like, that's why they say, go for a walk and clear your head. When you walk too, you are balancing both sides of your brain. You know, even if it's just around the block. And then just be mindful. Look at the things around you and what you see, the trees, the colors. We have another super moon, super full moon next week. So again, lots of big energy. So it's important to ground. You can ground your energy with water as well. Water is very cleansing, but also grounding. Maybe it's putting your feet in the sand. Even just being around a pool. Even just in your shower. All right, I am gonna bring in root chakra tuning fork vibration just to help clear out that chakra even more, any stagnant, stuck energy. And again, you can just listen or you can put the phone close to it and see if you can feel the vibration. so much. You know me, I love sound, so, and I love the tuning forks. I love, it's just, it's amazing. It's, yeah. And I love that you can feel it. Here too. Let's play the cymbal to clear it out even more. Bring in beautiful, radiant energy, vitality. Seven different layers of crystals, really powerful and healing. And I like the layers of the earth. We are going to move up to the sacral. It's important to drink lots of water. And I appreciate all the likes and shares. When you share this, it helps to get the healing out to others who might need it today. Maybe need a little extra support. So thank you. All right, let's move up to that sacral. Right above the root, orange in color. Sacral, the elements is water, the root is earth. Clearing out any heaviness or fullness that you might be feeling in that lower abdomen area, bladder, reproductive, lower back, sciatica. We hold the energy, the emotion of fear in our bladder and our kidneys. and heavier emotions here that we kind of tuck away and hide. Bringing in that water energy, water element to help kind of flush that area out, release, help you to go with the flow, let go of the need to control, resistance. Helping to balance our hormones here as well. I feel like especially in women, this area of the body can get very congested, like stagnant, for lots of different reasons. And maybe in males too, I don't know. But I know, definitely in females, it can get really, that's the best way I can describe it, as congested. Sometimes scar tissue from, you know, if you've had a C-section or any type of procedures here. Adhesions. Helping to, I want to like loosen for whatever reason, I'm focused on that today, loosen this area up, but to relax. Fear and worry, anxiety here, guilt, shame. And then bringing in that vibrant orange energy, passion, abundance, creativity, allowing that in your life, that feeling. It's our pleasure center. So the pleasures of life, sometimes we block that energy. Sometimes we're afraid. let's bring in the sacral tuning fork. Again, you can place it right over that area or just listen. Bring in singing bowl to help clear that even more, help that chakra instead of maybe a dull orange, muted, a vibrant, beautiful orange, radiant color. Actually, I'm going to bring in the selenite and then I'm going to do a little something. It's like, oh, I have an idea. Bringing in selenite, clearing that sacral, bringing light into that area, as well as light into your body. Clearing, cleansing. Liquid light for the soul. Drink some water, take a little water break. Oh, let's do these. So these are the crystal spirit oracle cards. And I was like, you know, it'd be fun to pull a card from here and see, pull a couple cards and see what crystals want to work with us today. I had to take out the ones that I don't have. So there was lots more, but I was like, oh, that could kind of be fun and different. We'll see. Who wants to come in? Oh. Well, of course. We know. Yes. I mean, like, really, you know, selenite. Of course. We know. Selenite always wants to work with us. Yes, yes, yes. All right. Yes, selenite. We, of course, will use you, but we'll choose another one too. That's funny. Right after I used the selenite. It's like, selenite. Yes, my favorite. Selenite is the best. So maybe we're just supposed to use selenite. I don't know. We'll see. What else? Oh, yes. Beautiful green fluorite. Well, there's lots of different fluorites, but I will definitely... We'll use this beauty. This is fluorite. This is rainbow fluorite. Isn't that so pretty? Rainbow fluorite. And we'll use this today too. Then we'll pull another one here in a minute. All right. That was funny. Okay, I'm gonna get a drink of water myself. Okay, we are gonna move up to the solar plexus. Really want, I'm feeling very, I also wanna use tiger's eye today. That sounds, tiger's eye is great for the sacral. And solar plexus, really. So solar plexus, center of our belly, beautiful radiant yellow energy. And the element is fire. Bringing back your strength and energy, good energetic boundaries, no leaking of energy, of our own personal power. Helping to clear any energetic cords from other people. So that is that feeling after maybe being around, you know, a certain group of people where you feel drained or you don't feel like yourself, especially if, yeah, you've been around heaviness or their energy might be negative or so it's clearing anything off of you that's not yours. And we don't even notice that we're doing that, and especially if you're an empath, you might be more prone to this. I always say it's kind of like that moth to light. They see a brightness in you, this radiance, and it's like, ooh, they have energy. And then they might leave feeling a lot better, and then you're like, oh, I'm tired. You know, or maybe you're the person that everyone goes to share their problems, their issues with. And here comes the fire trucks. You know, it is so funny. I swear to gosh, and now it's like, I can't remember when I was like, you know, every time I got on a live, I used to have the fire trucks that would go by, and it didn't happen for a really long time, and now it's back up. I do live, or I am right by a fire station. And well, we are on the solar plexus, which is fire. So really strengthening that, protecting your energy, helping you to release the tendency to people please, knowing that you are worthy, you know, to say no. You don't have to be everything to everybody, nothing to yourself. And this is also confidence, where we feel like our worthiness is from exterior praise, perfectionism, afraid, you know, to make a mistake if we don't deny our own feelings of this, perfectionism that we're not lovable or likable. And that can start off at a young age when we feel like we are responsible for how other people feel. So then we start taking on that responsibility. We don't even know we're doing it. So you are worthy of just because you are, because you're here, because you're breathing, because you're alive. You don't have to, everything for everyone. Your worth is in here. Your worth is inside you. Every time, that you're around your mom, and maybe when you were growing up, you felt, maybe she didn't really understand her own emotions, maybe you weren't allowed to express your feelings, or if you were upset or sad or angry, and that was like, quit your crying. Oh, I'll give you something to cry about, that old energy, right? And so then we, as kids, it's like, this is unacceptable. So I need to always be, and we internalize, and then we feel responsible if they're down, making them feel happy or safe or doing everything for them to feel loved, And with that, everyone's doing the best that they can, All right, let's bring in that solar plexus, clearing that, bringing in that beautiful sun, vitality, brightness. Thank you. Strengthening that solar plexus, your energetic boundaries. play singing bowl. Bring in more. Bring in a little rainbow fluorite, rainbow energy. Fluorite is great for focus, for clarity, for calming the mind. Green fluorite, our belly, our gut is associated a lot with our mental health. Our gut is the second brain. Digestion, how, you know, when there's a lot of information and you feel overwhelmed and you're trying to digest all that information, process, it's kind of the same thing. Okay, beautiful. Drink some water. We're gonna move up to the heart chakra. Let's pull one more card and see another crystal to use today. Garnet. Garnet. This looks like I do have garnet. I don't have. I'll get my garnet out. My garnet is red. Suppressatine garnet. I'm not exactly for sure, but I do have garnet. That's funny though. That is the yellow, like solar plexus energy. But my garnet is red. From yellow to orange to red and reddish browns. Yeah, I have two. Let me make sure. So I have this one is, which would be good for the heart chakra. But this one is raw. I don't know if you can see, but you see all these little pink, right here, these are all little garnet throughout here. Isn't that beautiful? Yeah. So we can use that for our heart chakra. And I have another one. I have, but I can't find it right now. Oh, I know where it is. It's on my selenite. Hold on. Can you see this? All right. Well, let's work on that heart chakra. Center of your chest, green in color, green and pink. So that'll be perfect with that garnet energy. Opening up that chest space. You can just really relax your shoulders, roll them back. Bring that chest forward. Really stretch your rib cage. Or clearing any congestion or heaviness, anything that feels tight or constricting, releasing that. The heart also associated with the lungs, so that, you know, we don't want that, anything that feels, constricted. The element of this chakra is air. And of course, unconditional love, compassion, forgiveness. Clearing any grief or sadness here. Again, any heaviness on that heart space, any worry or stress you might hold here. We don't want to hold that here. Also, that mid-back area. Drop the shoulders. Drop the shoulders, roll them back. Relax the neck. Sometimes when I, you know, I have visuals a lot of times of the different chakras and the energy. And one of the things I see that helps to calm that space, that heart space, relax it and clear anxiety would be if, like a newborn, like if you're an infant and you're laying on a nurturing, like mothering chest, and you're being held, and your ear is right up to her heartbeat, right up to her heart, and you can just hear that ding 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 ding, and you feel held, supported, safe, and it's that sound, that rhythmic sound, 11-11. That brought tears, oh, yeah, and that holding, and if you have ever, if you are a mother, or can remember that moment of holding that energy. That was the first sound that we ever heard in the womb. Also, visualize yourself now as an adult. One of the things I like to visualize is that energy, but laying, like if you were in a forest, a cool forest, on the ground, that earth energy, and you're laying just like your ear, you know, to the earth, your chest, your body, your arms out, your heart, you're connected to that earth energy. You can feel the coolness on your body. Your head is to the side, you feel safe, and you're bringing in, it's like Mother Earth, you can hear her heartbeat nourishing you, grounding you, protecting you. Yeah. Holding that sacred space for you to rest and heal, to rest, not feeling guilty for resting and receiving, not feeling like you have to do then something in return. It's literally just allowing your body to rest and heal. Space of unconditional love. Ooh, that was powerful, huh? Felt that. beautiful. I'm going to bring in some beautiful energy there. I'm going to bring in some rose. So, of course, I love using essential oils too. Lavender is one of my favorites. And I love rose. Rose in its like true form is very, 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 very expensive. So I actually use, I don't know, this one. It's like it has like a carrier oil, but I really like the smell of it. But rose actually, each essential oil, like everything, holds a frequency. It vibrates. And rose actually is the highest frequency, highest vibration. So helping with that heart, that pink, beautiful rosebud. Bring in the heart chakra, tuning fork. Just feel that sound, the vibration. Green Tara, Kuan Yin, Divine Feminine, Compassion, Love, Compassion to ease suffering here on Earth. Going to bring in that garnet pink energy. In its raw form, we got that earth energy too. Diamond in the rough. Drinking lots of water in my blood. All right, let's work on that throat chakra. Mm-hmm. again, dropping the shoulders, relaxing your neck, clearing that throat, any heaviness. If you have a sore throat or neck issues, thyroid, voice, vocal, clearing that. Working on this jaw, relaxing the tension here. Clearing all that overstimulation from our work, from life, from this space. Just really moving that, almost like we have on noise canceling headphones. It's like if you've ever, you know, and in the ocean or the pool, and you dive underwater, and it's kind of like that silence, that muffled, your eyes are closed. Self-talk, criticism of your own words, but others. Release. Allow that jaw just to drop, your head just to open, roll the shoulders back. Notice, are you like this, and do you like feel it? You know, it's like allow your body to be soft, your belly, just let it hang out. Express yourself from your heart space. You don't need to internalize and shove down your feelings, your emotions. Really clearing that. Sweeping that. Beautiful blue, ocean blue in color. Your words are powerful, your voice is powerful. Needs to be heard. Watch my time. let's bring in singing bowl. Move up to the crown and third eye. Drink some water. I think if I drink any more water, I will explode. Well, of course. And it's purple. See, we have like literally hit. So lepidolite, which is great for anxiety. And it's one of the best crystals to help calm. I have two different ones. So our crown is purple in color. It's supposed to be really wonderful for anxiety, one of the best crystals, because it holds the properties of lithium. That's what it's made from. All right, well, we'll use that on the crown. Third eye, which is indigo in color. I'm gonna kind of do both for time's sake. And then, of course, our crown is purple. In color. So really, for whatever reason, first I want to kind of go up to this crown. Excuse me. And clear just congestion up in the top of your head. Kind of that brain fog, that overwhelming. Connection to the divine, to source energy, just like light flowing down like a waterfall of light on the top of your head, down your body. relaxing your brow, relaxing.
Thank you.
Your jaw. Relaxing your eyes. Allowing your mind just to be clear. Even if it's just for this moment. Bringing that energy down. Bringing in beautiful healing energy for your highest good. Relaxing your nervous system. And just breathe. I will repost this to YouTube, so if you are new here, I repost all my lives to YouTube in case you miss them. You can go back and watch them, or if you found this helpful, it's always there for you to go back to and watch it. It's Sunflower Soul Healing, but the link is in my link tree. I'm also on Instagram. Make sure it has the blue check mark. There are fake accounts. This is my only account. This resonates. I do in-person sessions if you live in the beautiful state of Kentucky. And I also do distance and see people all over the world. They are a little different. This is more collective. It's personally for you. And all of that is in my link tree, or just go to sunflowersoulhealing.com and just no one ever reach out to you. And if you are looking for ways to help with your anxiety, for sleep, for rest, for stress. Of course, Reiki, getting out in nature. And I also have meditations on an app called Aura. You can check it out. That link is in my bio as well. And it will give you a 7-day free trial and a discount code. Lots of meditations on sleep and anxiety. Lots of professionals support. All right, let's bring in the third eye first. Each chakra, root, sacral, solar, heart, throat, third eye, crown, ears. One big one sealing in all this beautiful healing energy for your highest good, for the rest of your day. Evening, weeks ahead, days ahead. tourmaline. Really grounding us in our body. Singing one last time. I'm going to do two things. I'm going to turn on comments as I clean up, because I got to clean up because I do have someone coming for a session. And I probably will have to pause it for a second because I drink tons of water. You need to drink tons of water. I'll drink a little bit more. I have to go to the bathroom. But I'm going to clean up and this on if you guys have comments. And again, all my information, if you are new here, is in my link tree. So for sessions, in person, distance, I see people all over the world, wherever you are, over Zoom. Let's see what else. You know, I'm all Reiki'd. Social media, YouTube. I will repost this so you can always find all my lives there to go back and watch Sunflower Soul Healing, or click the little thing. Same with Instagram, make sure it has the blue check. And Aura, the app. I'm a creator on the meditation app. So if you need help with sleep, relaxation, stress, check it out. If you like my voice, the link is also there. All right. So welcome. Will I be doing it? Yes, I need to do the nighttime. You are so welcome. Yeah, I joke. I always have a hard time with the nighttime because I am a morning person and I get really tired in the evening. And I always say I only go live when I really feel like my energy is vibrant and good. So sometimes at night I have a harder time. You needed this morning. Oh, I'm glad, Sam. Thank you, Molly. That was wonderful. Kindly remind me of the purple crystal. Oh yes, that is lapidolite. And that's one of the best ones for anxiety. Lapidolite. Yeah, you are so welcome, Sonia. Having me relax and falling asleep at 10:30. Yeah, I know. Morning time, and it's like, oh man, yeah. That's why night would be great, right? I just need to be able to like my kids, and they all call me like grandma, because it's like, oh, I'm exhausted. It's, what time is it? It's late. It's like 8:45 at night. Jeez. Ridiculous. Oh, thank you. Yeah, so, but I need to do it. Well, you know what though? I'm really excited. One thing, and I'm trying to figure out, and I'm going to talk more about this. I cry when I play. Yeah, well, that's a good release. Let it go. Yeah, let it go. I'm going to be going over to England, and I'm going to be there for a couple weeks. I'm really excited, and I know that my days are very full, but I'm really hoping to bring you all along with me. We'll see how it goes. I don't want to promise anything, but I'm going to a lot of sacred sites. And so I'm hoping to bring you all along. So maybe with the time difference, when I can do a live, maybe in the afternoon there, it'll be evening in the US. So maybe the US people, you'll get some nighttime ones. Because I'll still be, yeah, but I'm excited. So I'm really hoping to, take you along and let you feel the energy and the ancient magical energy of where I'm going. I'm going to start off in London, and then I am going to Cornwall. So it's like, one day we're going to where they say like King Arthur was born. So like King Arthur and you know, the Knight's Table, the Mist of Avalon, the Holy Grail, the sacred stones, and a grove where it's this beautiful waterfall where, you know, they say it's like the Cornish Fae and the mermaids of Lyonesse in the Cornish, you know, the sea, St. Michael's, it's, yes, Cornwall. So if you have seen the show Poldark, oh gosh, I gotta hurry. See, this is, yeah, because I have a session. Poldark is filmed there, as well as Doc Martin, and it's on the ocean. There's St. Ives, Land's End, there's lots of just the Avalon, you know, Merlin, and all of that, really. But very exciting, because that's like on my mom's side and the women's side, our ancestors. So anyways, all right, I gotta go though. I love you guys, and because I gotta finish cleaning up, and your teeth are so white. Well, thanks. Well, thank you. All right, have a good day. Bye guys. Talk to you soon. I'll be back on this week. I don't know exactly when. Bye.